We begin to, or at least I begin to form a kind of my own philosophy of what an audio-animatronic show was in a park such as Disneyland or Disney World, or the same would be in Tokyo. One thing, nobody wants to stay in one attraction very long. And not staying in one attraction very long, you want to give a lot of show in a very short space of time. But what we really found, what I found here, was this show is built of a series of surprises. You do not know what's going to happen. You go in there and there's some birds, and I would say you can certainly assume that the birds are going to come to life. It's pretty obvious that they would. And they go through their little bit, and then things begin to happen. The fountain comes to life, and it moves to music. The lighting is so important in this. And I may not have the things in exact order, but when these big bowls that hold the flowers come down, the flowers begin to sing. And then the kind of key flowers come up and sing solo. Again, this is, it's a surprise. It's what you did not expect to see. And then finally the ceiling opens up and this birdmobile comes down. And then finally the whole room comes to life. Now this is, to me, this is the most exciting part of the show, is when this, I guess it's the Hawaiian war dance, comes on and black the room out and light, you know, and lightning flashes, and then even the wall decorations come to life. The poles that are holding up the building come to life. And I think this is really the extraordinary thing. Now this was the first sketch I think I did, when we were only gonna have maybe two heads on these. And we finally ended up with three heads. And this was a more or less a finished sketch that I did. And these are based on New Guinea art. The only thing is that I have taken a lot of liberties with it.
So I wrote